Hello everyone and thanks for serving with us in Afghan Voice Agency on May 11th. Pakistani Army Chief of Staff General Qamar Javed Bajwa met with Afghan President Ashraf Ghani and other leaders in Kabul on Monday. The media wing of Pakistan's military did not immediately respond to a request for comment or confirm the visit. It was not immediately clear what was discussed during the meeting. Neighboring Pakistan is regarded as a key player in Afghan peace process. In the past, Islamabad has been accused of harboring the Taliban, but in recent years, Washington and other Western powers have acknowledged its efforts to push the militant group to take part in peace talks. Bajwa on Monday also met Britain's Chief of Defense Staff, General Nicholas Patrick Carter, for talks on Afghan peacemaking. According to a statement from Pakistan's military media wing, the venue of meeting was not given. Salman Khalilzad, the U.S. Special Envoy for Afghanistan, has said the level of violence in Afghanistan is too high and that peace talks need to resume as soon as possible. Both sides have to be realistic about finding common ground. If there is no peace agreement, the alternative is not a Taliban victory. It is a long war, he said. Speaking to Germany's Der Spiegel, Khalilzad said he believes the Taliban leadership is in control of its fighters on the ground, but he warned if groups inside the Afghan Republic start to divide and each go their separate ways, which is a possibility and a dangerous one, that would encourage the Taliban, perhaps the hardliners, to seek a military solution. The U.S. military is breaking up its largest base in Afghanistan and dismantling equipment it is not taking home or transferring to Afghan forces. Amid an ongoing withdrawal from Afghanistan, the U.S. military said on Monday about 1,300 pieces of equipment had been destroyed so far. Associated Press quoted an unnamed official as saying more equipment would be destroyed before September 11th. At Bagram and other bases, American troops are taking stock of equipment they want to take home. Tens of thousands of metal containers are being shipped out on C-17 cargo planes or by road through Pakistan and Central Asia. The Biden administration has hailed the Taliban's announcement of a 3-day aid ceasefire. A State Department spokesman at the press commenting on an announcement on Monday called on the militant outfit to extend the ceasefire. Reuters quoted him as saying, "We call on the Taliban and Afghan leaders to engage seriously in ongoing peace process to ensure the Afghan people enjoy a future free of terrorism and senseless violence." The World Health Organization said that the coronavirus variant first identified in India last year is being classified as a variant of global concern, with some preliminary studies showing that it is spread more easily.
In consultation with our virus evolution working group and our epi teams and our lab teams internally, there is some available information to suggest increased transmissibility of B1617. This is a paper that has not undergone peer review, and it's a limited number of patients suggesting that there is some reduced neutralization, and as such, we are classifying this as a variant of concern at the global level.
Globally, we are now seeing a plateau in the number of COVID-19 cases and deaths, with declines in most regions, including the Americas and Europe, the two worst affected regions. But it is an acceptably high plateau, with more than 5.4 million reported cases and almost 90,000 deaths last week.
The Palestinian resistance movement Hamas has launched a barrage of rockets at Israeli targets following Israel's failure to observe a deadline set by the movement to pull out its troops from occupied East Jerusalem Al-Quds and the Holy Al-Aqsa Mosque compound. Meanwhile, Israeli's bombardments has continued early Tuesday, targeting areas in Palestinian territory of Gaza. This comes as, during a demonstration, Palestinians removed the Israeli flag and replaced it with the Palestinian one. As always, thanks for tuning in and until next time.